All right, guys. So today what we're doing, I am obviously not here, so you have a substitute, and the substitute was told to have you guys watch this video. I'm just going to walk you through how to set up our storyboard and how to actually do it so that you guys can work on that in class and get that done so that hopefully next class on Monday or Tuesday when we come back next week or over the weekend that we can start doing our filming. Now, what is a storyboard? A storyboard is basically a graphic organizer. It's a way to plan out your movie ahead of time. What you want it to look like, what's going to go where, how is this going to look, what camera angles do I need, what lighting do I need, what subjects do I need to have in there. It's a way to plan everything out ahead of time, which will save time and money when it comes to actually filming. Okay, so let's go into that. So, assuming your team captain has not done this, we're going to start from scratch. Okay, so first things first, we're going to go down to modules and we're going to click on modules. Now, I'm going to put this in student view. Okay, so this looks like your version. Okay, now the first thing that you guys are going to need to do, okay, is you're going to collapse all of your movies or all of your modules here, okay? And we're going to open this one right here. It says Module 5, Video Creation, 6th grade. So I'm going to click on that guy, and this is going to be our life hack project, okay? Now, down here underneath graded assessments, you're going to see this one that says Life Hack Video Storyboard. You're going to click on that, where the team captain is, more precisely. Click on the link, make a copy. And then they're going to bring it up on the screen. It'll look like this. Okay. Now, once you have done that, we're going to get rid of the words copy of right here at the front, and we're going to add our group number at the end. Okay. And then we're going to start filling this out. So, first and foremost, you're going to put the names of all three people in your group, the name of the hack that you're going to do. Okay. And what period you are. You're either 6A or 6B. Okay. Go ahead and do that now and go ahead and share that to your two teammates. I will let you pause the video here and let everybody get that done so that so that everybody stays in the same location. All right. Go ahead and hit pause. And when everybody's got the storyboard up on their screen, we can continue. All right. So now it looks like everybody's got this. Our team captains have made our document. They have shared it to us. We have moved it into our video production folder by clicking there. Okay, now it's time to actually start putting this stuff together. Okay, so this is what you and your teammates are going to be working on for the rest of class. And this is what I expect done when we come back on Monday or Tuesday so that we can start filming. Okay. Now, I've already gone ahead and put the label for each shot here. So this is, instead of a paragraph, this would be our title screen. This is our author screen. And so on and so on. You can see here I put our third one, has this ever happened to you? And then a wide angle version of you alternating showing the materials, a high angle version of it, then doing the same thing step by step. Wide angle, high angle, life hack solved, and then the ending credits. Okay. Everybody cool? This should be pretty simple so far. At this point, I'm going to stop this video, and your job is going to be to watch the next one that is attached. You know what? Strike that. We're going to do this way. It'll be even easier. I'll just redo this. It's pretty simple. All right. These are our questions. How to do this on a Google Doc. Okay. These are the questions. We have to answer these first. We answer these first so that it forces us to think about what we want to see over here. Now, the key in all of this, again, this is our sample, so use that. The key to all of it, draw it the way you want it to look. If you want it to be a close-up on somebody's face, then don't show me anything below their neck. If you want somebody moving, use the arrows. Remember, arrows inside the panel mean the subject is moving. Arrows outside the panel means the camera is going to be moving. And lastly, if you're not very good at drawing this stuff, then describe it using the lines. That's what these are for. To help you, these are the 7 required questions. So you're going to answer all 7 of these questions for each one of these shots so that you can, it forces you to think this through. So has this ever happened to you? So what do I want this to hear? I'm going to start filling this out. This is, who's my subject? My subject is my daughter, Kennedy. And Kennedy is going to be throwing a football to somebody off the screen. And I envision this on her to be about a cutoff at the chest, so a medium close-up. But the person off the screen, this is going to be a full shot for them, so I'm going to put that as well. Okay? Camera angles. Okay? This is going to be a horizon camera angle, and I'm going to put that right there in parentheses. Okay? But my subject is going to be a 3/4 profile because she's going to be looking downfield also off the screen with the camera. Okay? So I notice I put both of them on there. Camera angle, subject angle. Okay? Now, is there going to be any movement? Okay? Camera movements. Yes, the camera is going to follow the ball. And I'm just going to put throw. Camera will follow the throw and zoom as it's doing it. Okay? Are there any subject movements? Why, yes. Kennedy is going to throw the ball. Okay. Now, me personally, I don't like that this took up 2 lines, so I'm going to shrink this down to 1. Only because it makes the rest of these move down, and I don't want that. All right. Is there any dialogue? No, there's not any dialogue, but yeah, there is going to be any dialogue. She's going to yell, "Nice catch," to the person she throws the ball to. Okay. There we go. So now I've answered my questions. Now I actually have to draw it. So I click into the box, click insert, go to drawing, and click new. Now I'm going to use the shapes that are here provided to actually draw my image. Okay, so I'm going to go, we're going to get her head. There we go. It doesn't have to be perfect. There you go, 3/4 profile. She's a little bitty thing, so, you know, I'm just going to put that there, and she's going to be throwing the ball there, and make it look like she's wearing a t-shirt. There you go. We'll draw the ball here in her hand. And again, it doesn't have to be perfect. I've been drawing this for about 30 seconds here, guys, if that. That is not an impressive drawing, okay? She's going to throw the ball, so I need an arrow because arrows denote movement, so I'm going to grab an arrow here. And I'm just going to drag it off like this. Okay. And then I'm going to put a text box in there inside of it. And I'm going to write down Cam will follow the throw, zooming in as it goes. Okay. Oops. Zooming in. There we go. Now I'm going to take this. And I'm going to put it over here, and I'm going to tilt that guy like this, and I'm going to take the arrow and do the same thing, and I'm just going to tilt it so it looks like it's going upwards. There we go. Done. Over with. Save picture. And there it is. It goes right in there. It's super simple, and we've got everything planned out. And you'll notice that all that information matches up here. Now, you guys, when you're doing this, you're going to be drawing these things as they've shown. So this is somebody's hands. If this is a wide angle, somebody should be sitting at a desk. So we should see their head. We should see probably from their, probably they're a little lower than their chest up. So this would be a medium close up. I should see their hands. I should see them modeling some form of the material. then whatever the next material is, now I should, because this is the high angle, I should just see somebody's hand holding whatever the next material is. Okay. So we plan these out, make it look exactly the way it is. Everybody good? I hope you're all set to go. Team captains and class, go ahead and start getting working on this. Now, again, we want to finish this before the end of the period. So get to work. If you need help, just ask somebody, your partners, or ask a different team. Thanks, and I will see you when I get back on Monday or Tuesday.